Dear children, how are you all? Welcome back to the class. Last week you had a test. Hope that you had written the test well. Waiting for your answers papers to come. This class we are going to continue LCM of polynomials. So just before entering into the class, I want to recall what we have learned in the previous classes. That is LCM of polynomials we have learned in the classes. For LCM of polynomials, for numbers, we have to use the prime factorization method. For the variables, what should be selected? The variable with the highest power should be selected. Some homework was given in the previous class. Hope that you have done it. Anyway, it's my duty to clear your doubts. So let us enter into the homework. Exercise 3.2, second sum. Find the LCM of. The first sum is 4x square y, 8x square y square. For 4 and 8, we have to use the prime factorization method to calculate the LCM. You know already what is prime factorization method thoroughly. So for 4 and 8, by prime factorization method, LCM is 8. And for the variables x square and x square, y and y square. First we have to check whether there are common factors or not. So these are the common factors, both x and y are in both the terms. So x and y are the common terms. For x square and x square, we have to select x square, y and y square, what should be selected? The highest power should be selected, so y square. So LCM of these two polynomials is 8x square, y square. Look at the second sum. The polynomials given are minus 9a cube, b square, 12a square, b square. For leave the 9 now, later on in the answer we will join the 9. 9 and 12. What's the LCM by prime factorization method? 3 and 3 are the common. 3 is the common term, common factor. After that we have to carry on the process till 1 come. 1 come. So 3, 3, 2 and 2. Multiply all this, then it comes 36. Why I have written minus 36? Because in the question it is given that minus 9. Therefore in the answer we have to write minus 36. 36 is the LCM of 9 and 12. And for a cube and a square, a cube should be selected. B square and b square, it is b square. C is the uncommon factor. For LCM we have to choose the uncommon factor also. So our LCM of minus 9 a cube b square, 12 a square b square, C is minus 36 a cube b square c. The next sum is 16m minus 12 m square n square 8 m square. Three terms are given. First you have to calculate the LCM of 16, 12 and 8. By prime partition method, calculate the LCM, it is 48. As my negative is there in the question, in the answer also we have to give the negative sign. So 48, common factor, nothing is a common factor, all are uncommon factor. M and M square, M and M are there in the first and two terms, N square is in the second and third term. So for M and M square, we have to select M square. For N square and M square, we have to select M square. So the LCM of 16M minus 12 M square, M square and 8 M square is minus 48 M square, M square. Look at the fourth sum. Two polynomials are given, p square minus 3p plus 2. Next one is p square minus 4. What polynomials are this? Their degree is 2. Therefore, these are quadratic polynomials. What should we do? The quadratic polynomial should be factorized first. So, p square minus 3p plus 2 is factorized by this method. You are thorough in this method. That is, you have to select the number, two numbers. If you multiply them, the product should be 2. If you add them, the sum should be minus 3. So minus 1 and minus 2 are selected by here this single p square. Therefore, we will write p. So p minus 1, p minus 2. So this quadratic polynomial p square minus 3p plus 2 is factorized as p minus 1 and p minus 2. The second polynomial is p square minus 4. Take it as both are perfect squares. So p square minus 2 square. 4 can be written as 2 square. Now this is of the form a square minus b square. A square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So what is b square minus 2 square? P plus 2 into p minus 2. So factorization is over. After that we have to select. For selecting the LCM, first we have to choose the common factor. Which is the common factor? p minus 2 is the common factor in both. That should be written as first. Then the uncommon factors are p minus 1 and p plus 2. P minus 1 and p plus 2. So keep it in mind, for LCM, we have to select the common factor first and then the uncommon factors also. So now the LCM of p square minus 3p plus 2 and p square minus 4 is p minus 2 into p minus 1 into p plus 2. Next sum, fifth sum, LCM of 2x square minus 5x minus 3 and 4x square minus 36. These two are also the quadratic polynomials. So we have to factorize them first. Take 2x square minus 5x minus 3. By this method, T method, if you have to, the product is minus 6. How it is minus 6? 2 into minus 3. Then it is, the product of the two numbers is minus 6 and the sum of the two numbers is minus 5. 1 and minus 6 are the numbers. 1 into minus 6 is equal to minus 6. 1 plus minus 6 is equal to minus 5. Then we have to divide them by 2x, because here the x square term is, coefficient is 2. So 2x. When we divide by 2x, 6 and 2 are cancelled, then there is 3. Then it is factorized as 2x plus 1 and x minus 3. Next, we take the second polynomial, 4x square minus 36. Both are perfect square, but if you take 4 as common, 4x square is a perfect square, 36 also a perfect square. But instead of that, before, if anything is taken as common, take it as common. Here both these terms are divided by 4. Both of the terms can be divided by 4. So take 4 as common. When you take 4 as common, what's the meaning of the word taking as common? We are going to divide by the number which we are taking as common. So it becomes x square, and when 36 divided by 4, it becomes 9. Then 4 of x square minus 9. X square and 9 are perfect squares. Change them as x square minus 3 square. Now this is of the form a square minus b square, which is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So it changes 4 of x plus 3 into x minus 3. Now the factorization is over. So consider the common factor. X minus 3 is the common factor. Anyway, when we are writing the answer, first we have to write the numerant. So here 4 is a factor which is the uncommon one. As it is a numerant, it should be written as first. So 4, and then the common factor x minus 3, it has a single power, so it should be written as x minus 3. And the uncommon factors 2x plus 1 and x plus 3 are also written for LCM. Now the LCM of 2x square minus 5x minus 3 and 4x square minus 36 is 4 of x minus 3 into 2x plus 1 into x plus 3. Now we are going to see about the relation between LCM and GCD. This concept already you have learned in the lower classes for numbers. Just recall the concept before entering into the relation between LCM and GCD of polynomials. Just recall what you have learned in the lower classes. So let us consider two numbers, 12 and 18. Find out their LCM and GCD by prime factorization method. 2 and 3 are the common factors. These 2 and 3 are the uncommon factors. For calculating GCD, we have to take only the common factors. So 2 into 3, the GCD is 6. And for LCM, we have to take the common factors and also the uncommon factors. So 2 into 2 into 3 into 3, which is equal to 36. Now we have calculated the LCM and GCD of 12 and 18. Now let us go into the relation between LCM and GCD. Find the product of 12 and 18. 12 and 18 are the given numbers. Product of them. Product means we have to multiply them. 12 into 18 is equal to 216. That will be the first derivation. Then find the product of their LCM and GCD. Already we have calculated the LCM and GCD. LCM is 36. GCD is 6. Multiply them, which is also equal to 216. This is the second derivation. From the derivation 1 and 2, we can conclude that product of two numbers is equal to product of their LCM and GCD. Product of two numbers is equal to product of their LCM and GCD. The same concept can be applicable to the product of two polynomials is equal to product of their LCM and GCD. Let us see about that. Product of two numbers is equal to product of their LCM and GCD. Similarly, the product of any two polynomials is equal to the product of their LCM and GCD. Product of any two polynomials is equal to the product of their LCM and GCD. Let f of x and g of x be any two polynomials. Then we can derive that f of x into g of x. This dot stands for product. F of x into g of x is equal to their LCM into GCD. So f of x and g of x are any two polynomials. Then we can say that f of x into g of x is equal to their LCM into GCD. Let us use some illustrations to solve this. An illustration to prove the product of two polynomials is equal to product of their LCM and GCD. Let us consider the polynomials f of x and g of x. F of x is equal to 12 of x square minus y square. G of x is equal to 8 of x cube minus y cube. Now we are going to prove the product of f of x and g of x is equal to product of their LCM and GCD. So for proving that, first we have to calculate their GCD and LCM. For calculating GCD and LCM, these polynomials should be factorized. So take f of x is 12 of x square minus y square. So 12 of, this is of the form a square minus b square, split it as x plus y into x minus y. So f of x is now factorized as 12 of x plus y into x minus y. Now take g of x, which is 8 of x cube minus y cube. Substitute what is x, a cube minus b cube format. A cube minus b cube is equal to a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. So now 8 of x cube minus y cube is equal to 8 of x minus y into x square plus xy plus y square. Now the factorization is over. Now we are going to calculate the GCD. GCD of 12 and 8. Use factorization method in a rough column and calculate that it will be 4. So GCD of 12 and 8 is 4. And for the variables for GCD, we have to select only the common factor. What's the common factor? Only x plus y is the common factor in f of x and g of x. So that should be selected. Both are in power 1. So x minus y the power 1. So GCD is 4 of x minus y. Now we have to calculate the LCM. LCM of 12 and 8, do it in a column, it will be 24. Then the common factor should be selected. X minus y should be selected. And the uncommon factors are x plus y and x square plus xy plus y square. Take the uncommon factors also for LCM. Now the LCM is 24 of x minus y into x plus y into x square plus xy plus y square. This can be further simplified as by multiplying these two. X minus y into x plus y is equal to x square minus y square, which is of a minus b into a plus b is equal to a square minus b square common. So now the LCM is 24 of x square minus y square into x square plus xy plus y square. The illustration is not yet over. What we have done? We have factorized them and we have calculated GCD and their LCM. Then we have to prove that product of these two polynomials is equal to product of their LCM and GCD. Calculate f of x into g of x. F of x is 12 of x square minus y square. G of x is 8 of x cube minus y cube. Just to multiply only the numbers, numerics. 12 8s are 96. Then write down this variables as it is. So the product of f of x into g of x is 96 x square minus y square into x cube minus y cube. Will it be the first derivation? Now find the product of their GCD and the LCM. GCD is 4 of x minus y and the LCM is 24 of x square minus y square into x square plus xy plus y square. Carefully multiply them. Don't confuse it. First multiply the numerals. 4 into 24, which is 96. And write down x square minus y square. Then we can multiply these two. Just x minus y into x square plus xy plus y square is the expansion of x cube minus y cube. You may know that x minus y into x square plus xy plus y square is the expansion of x cube minus y cube. So that can be written as x minus y into x square plus xy plus y square can be written as x cube plus y cube. Now the product of their GCD and LCM is 96 of x square minus y square into x cube minus y cube. This is the second derivation. Now look at the first and second derivation. The product of f of x and g of x is equal to product of their GCD and LCM. So from 1 and 2 we can conclude that f of x and g of x is equal to GCD into LCM. This dot stands for the product.
Hope that you have understood the concept. What was the concept you learned? The relation between GCD and LCM of polynomials. Here is your homework, exercise 3.3, first sum. Do that. Just three sums are there. If you have any doubt, I will explain it in the next class. Thank you, children.